Good morning, students. Welcome to the HTML class. Open your books at the page number 24. Till now, we have covered different topics like paragraph tag. We have done heading tag, line break, background color, font elements, list elements, subscript and superscript. We have discussed image tag and its various attributes. We have discussed links and its various attributes. In the last lecture, we have started the topic that was form, and we have discussed input element, type element, text box and password. And in today's lecture, we will do the topics that are radio buttons, check box and drop down list. For that, we are having that is a radio button. If we want to insert any radio button in our form, then we are using this radio button property. For that, we are having its term radio button allow the user to choose one option from the several options. Means in the form, if we are having more than one options and we need to choose only one option, then we are using this radio button. In the example of the book, they have given your age is in between 5 to 10 years or 20 to 30 years, means the user can choose any option from the given option. And its syntax is input type is equal to radio. In the last lecture, on the place of this radio, we have discussed text box and password. Now we want to insert the radio button. That's why we are using its type is equal to radio. Now I'll show you practically that how to use the radio buttons. Come to your notepad. In the last lecture, we were designing the form. Now, let's suppose I want to write choose your gender. And I will write BR to bring the cursor to the new line. I'll type input type is equal to radio. And I will write male. I'll write BR. I will copy this line so that I can make another radio buttons. As many as radio buttons I want, I can use this input type is equal to radio. And in the second line, I will write female. I have written input type is equal to radio and male. Input type is equal to radio. I have written female. I'll save my work. I'll close my notepad. I'll show you the output. See, on the output screen, these round buttons come and these are called radio buttons. I have used input type is equal to radio two times. That's why it is coming two times. Now see, if I'll click on it, this male property is selected. If I'll click on it, this female property is also selected. But in the definition, I told you that only one option will be selected from the given options. For that, what to do? We have to use its one attribute, that is name. I'll open my notepad again. I'll show you how to solve this problem. For that, with each radio, I will put my one space and I will write name is equal to, let's suppose A, whatever the name I want to write, I will write name. Name is equal to same name I have to give, A, B, C, hello, whatever. I'll write this one. I use this name with each radio button. I'll save my work. I'll close my notepad. Now see, again, these are the radio buttons. I click over here, or I will click over here. Only one option is selected as our definition was there. Means only one option will be selected and second will automatically be deselected. Now come to the book for the next topic. Next topic we are having, that is checkbox. Checkbox is our next control. It works like the radio buttons, but one difference is there. In the radio button, we can choose only one option from the given options. But with the help of check box, we can choose more than one option. Mean multiple options we can choose with the help of check box. And its key term is check box allow to choose more than one option from the given options. For that, on the place of this radio button, we will write checkbox. So its syntax will become input type is equal to checkbox. Now I'll show you practical that how to use the checkbox. Come to the notepad where we were doing the work. Let's suppose I want to write choose your hobbies. One person can have more than one hobby. Choose your hobbies. And I'll type br to bring the cursor to the new line. Input type is equal to, now we will write checkbox without space. I have written checkbox. I'll type cricket. I'll do br. Now I'm going to copy this line, coding line. I'll copy this, and as many as checkbox I want to use, I can paste it. And I will change this game, cricket, hockey, and I will write football. Right? I use checkbox on the place of radio. Now see, I have written one checkbox, cricket, second, hockey, and third, I have written football. I'll save my work. I'll close my work and I'll come to the output screen. See, now these square boxes came, that are called check boxes. Round shape are the radio buttons and square boxes are check boxes. Now see, if I'll click on this or I will click on this, I can choose more than one option. But in the radio button, I can choose only one option from the given option. That was the difference between radio button and check boxes. Now come to the book. In the book we are having next topic, that is drop down list. A drop down list, what is drop down list? Drop down list allow the user to select one item from the list. Means a drop down will come and the user can select any one option from the. And for that we are having, that is a select element. And what is select element? Select element allow the user to select one of the set of the textual labels. Means the labels will come and the user can choose any one label. For that we are having its syntax, that is select. We will use select tag on the place of input type. Then in the options we can make our list. And at the end we will close this select tag. We are opening the select tag and closing it, so it is a container tag. Now come to the practical work. Let's suppose in the notepad I want to write choose your city. I'll write choose your city and I will write select. As I told you, the tag will be select. And in the I'll use second tag, that is option. Let's suppose I am writing Amritsar. I'll close this option. Option tag, I'm going to copy this. Control C. I'll paste it as many as list I want. And I'll change the city name. I'll type Jalandhar. And I'll write Ludhiana. And at the end, I will close this select tag. As many as list I want, I'll save my work. And I'll show you the output. For that, we will close our work. And come to the output screen by double clicking on it. See, last we have done the drop down list, choose your city, and this become my drop down list. I'll click on this black arrow. My options will come Amritsar, Jalandhar and Ludhiana. As many as options I want, I can choose. Let's suppose I want to choose Jalandhar or Ludhiana, I can choose. In this lecture, we have done radio buttons. These round shapes are radio buttons. One option from the given options we can choose. We have discussed check boxes, multiple options we can use, and we have done this drop down list. Any one label we can choose from there. While using these all controls, text box, password, radio button, check box, and this drop down list, we can make our form as per our requirement. On the basis of these controls, we have given you different project works. Do that project works with the help of school links. Thank you so much.